It's Dana again, and today I'm going to do another take on the whole what's in my purse, what's in my bag thing that I see people doing. Today, I had to go to jury duty, and I actually was selected. So not only did I pack my bag to go to jury duty today and think about what I wanted to bring and how I wanted to be prepared, but now I need to also continue to pack my bag possibly for the whole rest of the week, where we've been told this is going to be several days, and so it's going to be like a home away from home, and I definitely want to be comfortable. I don't know about y'all, but I like to have what I need. Oh, and there's my cat, Audrey, chilling out in the back. Okay, so anyway. Okay, first of all, I totally dressed comfortable. This is a knit, really soft, comfy shirt, and then I dressed in layers, and it was absolutely perfect. I will definitely kind of replicate this sort of thing tomorrow. It's pretty cold here in Texas right now, so, you know, a couple of days a year, it gets kind of cold here. Anyway, and so I wore a long sleeve, soft t-shirt, and then also kind of a long, comfy cardigan that was really soft. And then probably the best thing I did was for my scarf this morning, I wore one of my one of my big pashminas, and I had it just regular scarf way this morning, but this afternoon I was kind of able to wrap myself in it almost like a blanket. So I will definitely be bringing one of these again tomorrow as well. So today I kind of consolidated everything into one bag. Usually I carry several different things to work, you know, purse, bag, this or that. But today I put it all together in my, what is normally my work bag. And so this is the, Vera Bradley Vera tote. I think it's just called the Vera, and it's awesome. It's got lots of pockets, and it's just really easy to organize yourself. And so I'm going to share with you what I brought and whether I actually used it, and will definitely bring it again, and whether I didn't touch it at all and will be putting it aside for tomorrow to lighten my load. So first of all, I brought a book, and it is a book I totally want to read. Tim Gunn's Golden Rules. I actually got this last year for Christmas from my mom. Cannot wait to read it. I've been saying that for a year, and I really will read it. However, if you haven't read a book in over a year that you've been meaning to read, you're not going to read it on the day you have jury duty either. So I won't be bringing this again. Okay, the next thing I brought is my work calendar. It's the Uncalendar, which I absolutely adore. I'll have to do something on this, a video of some sort. This is the most awesome calendar. It doesn't have regular written in. It doesn't tell you exactly how you have to use it. It's just got lots of different areas for you to chunk out your thinking and planning. They call themselves, it's the Uncalendar, and they kind of say that they cater to, it's the calendar for creative people. So I like that. I like to think of myself as creative. So anyway, calendar. Didn't look at it today. Since I've been chosen for a jury, I will definitely not have time to do any calendar planning, so I won't be bringing this back again today. But the thought was there. The next thing I brought, I cracked myself up. I'm not in the classroom anymore, but there's something about the whole teacher in me that makes me not have to just bring one pencil, but I had to have a whole bag selection of every color highlighter, various Sharpies and pencils and pens. Okay, tomorrow, first of all, the court supplies you with a pencil. I might bring one as a backup. In fact, I'll take it out now. I'm going to bring one pencil as a backup, and that's it. I'm not bringing back my, what are these called? My little art satchel. Oh, goodness. It's like, I don't know. Anyway. I also brought a journal, and I didn't write in it at all. I have been, you know, kind of mapping out some of my goals and resolutions for the new year, and so it's on my mind, and there is stuff I want to do to it, but again, there's better people watching to be done when you're in that big waiting room for the jurors. I mean, there were 500 plus people there today. I didn't write in a journal. I watched everybody else doing their thing. Oh, it's such an interesting thing how many different areas of and walks of life that people that come together. Very interesting. Okay, the next thing I brought was my iPad, and I definitely used that. They had Wi-Fi. It was super fast. I was actually able to watch a couple of YouTube videos before I got called. I didn't have much time, though. I was pretty much called mid-morning, and I was out of there for the rest of the day. But I'll definitely bring it again because we have some nice long breaks, and it'll be fun to be able to have something to do whatever I want. So I will definitely bring my iPad. It's so small, so light. Definitely bring that again. Let's see. I brought my phone charger. I actually am glad that I brought this today. I don't even know why I grabbed it. But I think because my phone was having to work so hard and trying to connect as I was using it today to text and whatnot, that it actually did drain pretty fast. But I'm not going to bring it tomorrow. I have another idea that I'm going to share with you, so I'm not bringing this either. Okay, earbuds. I will definitely be bringing the earbuds. That was totally helpful when I was watching my YouTube videos, so keep that in there. That's light and not a problem. And then I downsized my wallet. So instead of having my giant wallet, I just kind of brought my necessities into my little wallet, and that's all I needed. Of course, it's very important, you know, sometimes when I downsize, like, to go walk or something, I don't bring much of anything, but I did, not knowing how, you know, parking and the cash I'd need and things like that, I brought everything I needed, but I definitely was able to downsize and not bring my giant wallet, so that was a good thing. I brought my little makeup bag, and I'm not going to go through everything that was in here, but a couple of things that were totally helpful that I had with me today. Eye drops were a must. Especially once I got into the court, there's so much you have to pay attention to that I tend to not only just pay attention, but I kind of listen with my eyes too. I tend to go, and I think that dries them out. I don't know what it is, but eye drops were a must, and I'll definitely keep those again. Also, hand cream. I'm so glad I had this little hand cream with me. That was very helpful. And then other, you know, Odden makeup items that I just carry on a day-to-day basis. So that was helpful. And this bag is so awesome because it's just all those little things, just chunk, 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 just like fit so nicely into the pocket areas. I love that. The other thing I threw in there was my lunchbox, and this was awesome. I wasn't sure what the situation would be as far as anytime you go to this sort of thing, it's like, you know, will there be access to, you know, be able to get lunch easily? And I didn't want to add extra stress. And so I actually just brought my own lunch, and that was absolutely perfect. I stuck this in there, and then what I love about this bag is once it's empty, it's actually not quite empty. I didn't eat my, what are these called? Little cutie. I love cuties, and it's cutie season. So anyway, I didn't eat my cutie, but once this is empty, it's great because it just folds down to nothing, and I'm able to put it in my bag. So I'll definitely bring this. We'll bring my lunch with me tomorrow and some coffee. So that worked out really well today, and I'll definitely do that again. Okay, I did pretty good, and actually I'm only going to end up, as you can see, continuing to bring about 30% of what I brought. But there are a couple of things, I have just a couple of little things I'm going to share with you that I was like, I didn't have that today, and I need to have that. One is Kleenex. I definitely need to have Kleenex. What is it about the idea of anytime you're not in a situation to be able to, like, blow your nose, or it's when you can't. It's when you don't have the tool you need to be able to blow your nose. So I didn't have to blow my nose today, but I definitely would have enjoyed being able to have a Kleenex when I had a runny nose. I don't know. It's like, I bet you anything that if I hadn't have had jury duty today and I would have been still on vacation at home or at work, I bet you my nose would not have run at all. But just because I was on jury duty, I had a runny nose. And so I've got my little Kleenex and I will already put those in the bag. Okay, the next thing is to prevent my phone having issues, because I did. It was on red by the end of the day, and so I don't want that to happen again. So tomorrow, I'm just going to modify my phone settings. I absolutely keep my, like, especially the brightness, I keep it up way to the top, because I'm like, why not? I mean, I see it really easily. I love it that way, but for tomorrow, I can definitely save a lot of juice by, like, modifying that phone setting. Also, I had that silly Wi-Fi on, and I should have turned it off earlier than I did because it kept searching for a Wi-Fi connection. So tomorrow, I'm going to modify my phone settings so that hopefully my battery will last a little bit more easily throughout the day. Okay, hand sanitizer. I think I'm the only girl on YouTube that does not use hand sanitizer. I don't carry it with me. All of you guys, every time I watch one of your what's in my purse, what's in my makeup bag, what's in my car, what's in my whatever, y'all have hand sanitizer everywhere. I just don't carry it. It's really, I don't know. I guess that's a little bizarre to some of y'all, but I don't know. I just, anytime I feel the need, oh, there she is again. No problem. Mom's making a video, I'm gonna take a bath. So, I love you, girly. I'm just kidding. Okay, anyway, so I just kind of think to myself, what was I saying about hand sanitizer, that if I need to wash my hands, I'll go wash my hands, but I don't know, I just don't feel the need to carry hand sanitizer. I just go wash my hands if I feel like I need to do that, but when you're in, like, such a public area and you're just not able to maybe wash your hands as easily as you normally could, today was definitely a day where a little thing of hand sanitizer would have been nice. It would have been. I thought about that a couple of times, especially when I was leaving today and I was going down the parking garage and touching the railings of the stairs. They were really steep. I was like, that would be nice to, like, have some hand sanitizer, but I don't. So I'm not going to be able to put this in my bag for this year, but in 3.5 years when I'm called again, I'm going to have hand sanitizer. So, okay, note for the future. The last thing that I didn't have with me today that I will definitely have tomorrow is gum. I'm not a smacker, so I know that's not going to be an issue, but it would have been nice today to just have had some gum. And so I'll have gum tomorrow. The other tip, so that's it. That's what I brought and how I'm going to modify it for tomorrow. And I just thought I'd share this with you in case any of you have jury duty in the future and you want to be able to not only bring what you need, but I'm going to end up downsizing what I brought and it's going to be awesome and it's going to be great. But I wanted to share that with you. The other tip I wanted to share, oh my goodness, please don't wear perfume or cologne when you go to jury duty. I tell you, it's like such a small space really for 500 plus people and the ceiling seems so low and you're just like in this holding area. And a little bit of perfume or cologne goes so far. I did not wear any today. I actually kind of always think about that. Like, what am I doing today? Am I going to be in a situation where that's, you know, am I going to be in a situation where I'm more in somebody's space than I normally am? And so I did not wear perfume or cologne today, but several of my neighbors did. And so, I don't know, maybe they'll watch this video before tomorrow and they won't be wearing as much perfume or cologne. But anyway, thank you for watching. If you have an idea of something that you bring when you're on jury duty, please post it and let me know, because, you know, it's a tough day, it's a long day, and it's sort of like you're just, you know, you're not in your comfort zone. And so having these little things that make that day just a little bit easier is a good thing. So I'm going to say goodbye, and so is Audrey. Say goodbye, Audrey. And thank you again for watching. I look forward to posting another video soon. Thanks for watching this one. Bye.